Την όντως Θεοτόκος εμεγαλύνομε.
Είσαι κράτος εν βραχίων ιευτού, διευκόρτης εν υπερηφάνους διανοίας καρδίας αυτών.
Την τιμιωτέραν των κερουβίν,
και εν δοξωτέραν ασυγκρίτως των σεραφείν. Την αδιαφθόρος Θεόν λόγον τεκούσα, την όντως Θεός όχον σε μεγαλύνομε.
Καθήλε δυνάστας από θρόνων και ύψωσε ταπεινούς, δυνώντας ενέπλησεν αγαθών και πλουτούντας εξαπέστειλε καινούς.
Την τιμιωτέραν των κερουβίμ, και ενδοξωτέρα να συγκρίτως των σεραφείμ, την αδιαφθόρος Θεόν λόγον τεκούσαν, την όντως Θεοτόκον σε μεγαλύνομε. Στην Ελέους και τους ελάλησε προς τους πατέρας ημών, το Αβραάμ και το σπέρμα δι' αυτού έως αιώνος, την τιμιωτέρα των κερουβίν, και εν δοξωτέρα να συγκρίτως των σεραφείμ, την αδιαφθόρος Θεόν λόγον τεκούσα, την όντως Θεοτόκον σε μεγαλύνομαι.
Θεοτό και η ελπής πάντων των χριστιανών, σκέπε φρούρι φύλατε τους ελπίζοντας εισέ. Εν όμως σκιά και γράμματι τυποκατήδομεν η πίστη, πανάρσεν τον την μήτραν διανοίγων Άγιον Θεό, δύο πρωτότοκον λόγων, Πατρός Ανάρχου Υιόν, πρωτότοκουμένον μήτρη, απειράνδρου μεγαλύνομε.
Έτι και έτι εν ειρήνη του Κυρίου δεηθώμε. Αντιλαβώς όσον ελέησον και διαφύλαξον ημάς ο Θεός της συγχάρητη.
Κύριε
της Παναγίας Αχράντου υπερευλογημένης, εν δόξω Δεσποίνης ημών Θεοτόκου και Αη Παρθένου Μαρίας, με τα πάντων των Αγίων μνημονεύσαντες, εαυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωήν ημών, Χριστό το Θεό παραθώμεθο. Ότι σε ένωση πάσε δυνάμεις των ουρανών και σύ την δόξαν αναπέμπωση, το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύμα την ειν και αείμ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν. Άγιος Κύριος ο Θεός ημών.
Άγιος Κύριος ο Θεός ημών,
υψώτε Κύριον των Θεών ημών, και προσκυνείτε το υποποδίο των ποδών αυτού.
Ότι Άγιος
εν σώμα τη διατελών των αγγέλων των βίων υπήλθες ως περασαρκός και το κόσμο εδείχθης φωστήρα η λαμπεστατός και της πάσιν έδειξας Αντώνιε Θεοφόρε μοναζόντον το κλαίος ασκητών η καλονή και των πατέρων η δόξα.
Ελπίς του κόσμου αγάπη Θεότον και Παρθένε της Ιωχρός μου Δέσποινα προστασίον ετούμε η θλίψε εις τις νεσιέντες και κλειδονιζομένη του βίου της τραυμίας στην όναυρας των παθών το λιμέναν εις Θεού εκβίβασον θέλημάτων.
Αυτής κρίμα εν γραπτόν, δόξα αυτή εστε πάση τη σωσή
αυτού.
Προσκυνώ και δοξάζω. Και αν υμνώ Χριστέ την συν εκτάφουν ανάσταση, δεις ηλευθέρωσας ημάς εκ των του άδου αλήτων δεσμών και δωρήσω το κόσμο ως Θεός ζωήν αιώνιον και το μέγα ελέον.
Ενείτε τον Θεόν εν της Αγής αυτού, ενείτε αυτόν εν στερεώματι της δυνάμεως αυτού. Κύριε και κριτήριο παρέστης υποπηλά του κρινωμένος, αλλού καπελήφθη στον θρόνο το Πατρί συγκαθεζομένος και Αναστάς εκ νεκρών των κόσμων ηλευθέρωσας εκ της δουλείας του αλλού τρίου ως ικτήρμον και φιλάνθρωπος.
Ενείτε αυτόν επί τες δυναστείες αυτού, ενείτε αυτό κατά το πλήθος της μεγαλοσύνης αυτού. Κύριε, είχε ως νητός εν ημίω σε Ιουδαίοι σε κατέθετο, καλός βασιλέα υπνούντα, στρατιώτες εφυλατρών. Και ο ζωής της αυρών, σφραγίδιες φραγίσαντο, άλανες τις και παρέσχες, αυταρσίες τες ψυχές ημών.
Εν είτε αυτόν εν ήχος σάλπιγκος, εν είτε αυτόν εν ψαλτηρίο και κιθάρα, Κύριε, όπλον κατά του διαβόλου, το σταυρό σου ημίν δεδοκάς. Φρύε τη γάρ και τρέμει, μη φέρον καθαράν αυτού την δύναμη, ότι νεκρούς ανιστά και θάνατον καθήργησε δια τούτο προσκυνούμεν την ταφή σου και την έγερση.
Της Αγίης της εν τη γη αυτού εθαυμάστος εν ο Κύριος όσοι επάτερ Αντώνιε συν των ζυγών του Χριστού, επί όμων θαράμενος των σταυρών την έπαρση, του σατάν καταβεύλικας και τα σερήμους πόλης ανέδειξας και του διατρόπου της πολιτείας σου. Ω παμακάριστε ασκητών το καύχημα δύο Χριστών απαύστονση και τεβε ελεηθήνε ημάς.
Εν είτε αυτόν εν τη βάλισε βήχης, εν είτε αυτόν εν τη βάλισε λαγμού, πάσα πνοή εν εσάτω τον Κύριο, όσοι επάτερ Αντώνιε, δια την όντο ζωή, εν το μνήματι κέρδισε, μη δολός πτωουμένος. Προσβολάς του αλάστορος, τας μετακτύπων και κρότων όσιε, τες δε ευχές σου ταύτας ιδάφησας. Ο καρτερό ψυχε, της ερήμου πρόταρχε, διότενην πάντες εγερερωμέν και μακαρίζομεν.
Τίμιος εναντίου Κυρίου ο θάνατος του οσίου αυτού, πίστη συνερθόντες πάντες σε ως ασκητήν του Χριστού, σε τιμόμεν Αντώνιε γεγηθός χαροδευσάς, εν ερήμης απέστατα καθηγητής τετάφτης εγένου πιστός. Όθεν τσιπάντες ημείς κραυγάζομεν, ο παμακάριστε μοναστόν το καύχημα, το λυτρωτή απαύστος οικέτευε εις το σωθήνε ημάς.
Mm-hmm.
Χριστέ, ο Αρδαμάνα και Κρήτε, η Κατάρανε νεκρότε, η Εύα ηλευθερότε, ο θάνατος τε θάνατοτε, και η μη σε ζωπίτη με, διό ανινού δεχόμε, ευλογητός Χριστός ο Θεός ημών, ο ούτως ευδοκίσας δόξασι.
Δόξασι τον δείξαντι το φως, δόξα εν υψίστης Θεό, και επί γης ειρήνη, εν ανθρώπης ευδοκία.
Προσκυνούμεν σε, δοξολογούμεν σε, ευχαριστούμεν συνδύα την μεγάλη δόξα. Κύριε Βασιλεύ, εφουράνιε Θεέ, Πάτερ Παντοκράτο, κύριε Ιεμονογένετο, Κύριε ο Θεός ημών την εκτενή τάθηνη και σύν μπορούσε ξεπαρά των σοδούλων και ελέησον ημάς κατά το πλήθος του ελέου σου και του συκτηρμού σου κατάπτυξον επί μας και επί πάντα των λαών σου τον απεκδεχομένο το παρασομπουσίον ελέους.
Δόξα την δέησιν ημών, ο καθημένος εν δεξιά του Πατρός και ελέησον
ημάς. Την ημέρα πάσα τελειά να γίνει ειρηνική και να μάρτυ τον παρά του Κυρίου της όμεθα. Αγγελών ειρήνης πιστών οδηγών φύλακα των ψυχών και των σωμάτων ημών παρά του Κυρίου της όμεθα. Συγγνώμη και άφηση των αμαρτιών και των πλημελημάτων ημών παρά του Κυρίου της όμεθα. Τα καλά και συμφέροντα τα ευτυχές ημών και ειρήνη του κόσμου παρά του Κυρίου της όμεθα. Χριστιανά τα τέλη της ζωής ημών, ανώδυνα ανεπέσχυντα ειρήνικα και καλή να απολογεί την επί του φοβερού βήματος του Χριστού ετησόμεθα. Της Παναγίας Αχράντου υπερευλογημένης εν δόξου δεσποινής ημών Θεοτόκου και υπερτένου Μαρίας, με τα πάντων των Αγίων μνημονεύσαντες σε αυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωή ημών Χριστό το Θεό παραθόμεθα.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, ο Θεός των Πατέρων ημών, και ενετών και δεδοξασμένων
το σκεφαλάσιμο του Κύριου κλείνουμε εσύ Κύριε
εις τους αιώνας αμήν.
Γέννητο Κύριε το έλεο σου εφημάς καθά περιλπίσαμεν επίσε.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε διδαξών με τα δικαιώματα.
Αμήν σοφία ευλόγησον.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε
αμήν στερεώσε Κύριος ο Θεός την Αγία και μόνο των πίστων των ευσεβών και ορθοδόξων πιστήνων στην Αγία Εκκλησία και την πολιτεύτης αιώνας αιώνων. Αμήν. Την τιμιωτέραν των χειροβήμ και ενοξωτέραν ο Συγκρήτος ο Σεραφείμ την Αδία Θόρος τον ούμε το κούσαν την όντως το τόκον σε μεγαλυνόμεν. Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίο Πνεύματι κυρίν και Άγιε και Ιησούς αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Πάτερ Άγιε ευλόγησον.
Σε την ψυχή μου ότι μαρτώνσει.
Κύριε προσέκατε φυγών, διδαξών με του ποιήν το θέλημά σου, ότι σύ ο Θεός μου.
Ότι πάρασι πηγή ζωής, εν το φωτί σου οψούμε θα φω.
Παράτηνον το ελαιό, Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος.
Σα Πατρί και Υιό και Άγιο Πνεύματι.
Και αεί και εις τους αιώνας.
στον αιώνων αμήν.
Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Ευλογημένη η Βασιλεία του Πατρός και του Υιού και του Άγιου Πνεύματος νυν και άγιοι και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Peace from above for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For the peace in the whole world, for the stability of the holy churches of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For this holy temple, for those who enter with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For our Archbishop and Father Iakovos, for the honorable presbyters, the deacons in the service of Christ, and all the clergy and laity, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For the President of the United States, for those in civil authority, for armed forces, for all the American nation, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For this parish and city, for every city and country, and for the faithful who live in them, let us pray to the Lord.
For seasonable weather, for the abundance of the fruits of the earth, for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
For travelers by land, sea, and air, for the sick, the suffering, the captives, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
For deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by your grace. Remembering our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever-Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To
To thee belong all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Amen.
The praise of the Theotokos, Savior, save us.
Ευλόγη ψυχή μου των Κύριων και μη επιλαμβάνω πάσας, τας ανταποδώσεις αυτού.
Τες πρεσβείες εις Θεοτόκους,
Κύριος εν το ουρανό, ετοίμασε τον θρόνον αυτού και βασιλεία του πάντων δεσπόζει.
By the praise of the Theotokos, Savior, save.
Και έτι εν ειρήνη του Κυρίου δεήθωμεν.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Αντιλαβούς όσον ελέησον και διαφύλαξον ημάς ο Θεός τη συγχαρητή.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Της Παναγίας Ακράντου υπερευλογημένης εν δόξω δεσποίνης ημών Θεοτόκου και αη Παρθένου Μαρίας με τα πάντων των Αγίων μνημονεύσαντες εαυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωήν ημών Χριστό το Θεό παραθώμεθο. Ότι σώεν το κράτος και σου εστίν η βασίλεια και η δύναμη και η δόξα του Πατρός και του Υιού και του Αγίου Πνεύματος νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Εν η ψυχή μου τον Κύριος εν εσύ ο Κύριος εν τη ζωή μου. Ψαλώ το Θεό μου, έως υπάρχω.
Σύρας ο Σαν Αυκάρ, ούτε η βράδυ,
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Commemorate in our most holy, pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, the Mother of God and ever-Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another in our whole life to Christ our God. For thou, God, art good and lovest mankind, and to thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Προσκυνήσομεν και προσθέσομεν Χριστό. Σώσον ημάς Υιέ Θεού, ο Αναστός εκ νεκρών.
Jesus, that is, O
εσύ την Παρθενία ανεφύλαξας, εν δικημίσι των κόσμων που κατέλειπες Θεό το και μετέστης προς την ζωήν, μη την υπάρχουσα τη ζωής, και τες πρεσβείες τεσές λυτρουμένη εκ θανάτου τας ψυχάς ημών.
Ο Μήτρον Παρθενήν κοιναγίας σας τον τόκο σου και χείρας του Σημαίων ευλογήσας ως έπρεπε. Προφθάσας και νυν έσωσας ημάς Χριστέ ο Θεόν. Ειρήνευσον εν πολέμης το πολίτευμα και κρατέως των βασιλείς τους ηγάπησας. Ο μόνος φιλάνθρωπος.
Let us pray to the Lord.
For the good and holy, and to thee we ascribe glory. To the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Holy God, rest among thy saints, and glorified by the cherubim, and praised by the seraphim, with thy voice. Worship by all the hosts of heaven, thou who hast brought all things out of nothingness into being, thou who hast created man in thine own image and likeness, and hast adorned him with all thy favors, thou who givest to the supplicant wisdom and prudence, and looked not on every sinner. But hast set forth a way of repentance unto salvation, thou who hast accounted us, thy humble and worthy servants, worthy to stand at this time before the glory of thy holy altar, and to bring to thee adoration and praise, do thou, Master, accept me for the wrath of us sinners. Thrice holy Him, visit us in the righteous, forgive us of all transgressions, voluntary and involuntary, sanctify our souls and bodies, and grant that we may worship Thee in holiness all the days of our life. Through the intercessions of the Holy Theotokos and of all the saints, who from the beginning of time have pleased Thee, for Thou art God, and holy, then ascribe glory to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Προσφωμέν.
Τιμιώσεν αντίον Κυρίου
ο θάνατος του Οσίου αυτού. Τι ανταποδώσομεν το Κυρίο περιπάντων.
Σοφία.
Προς Εβραίους επιστολής Παύλου το ανάγνωσμα.
Προσκομεν.
Αδελφοί, πείθεστε τη σιγουμένη Σιμών και υπήκητε αυτής γάρα γρυπνούσιν υπέρ των ψυχών ημών. Ως λόγος αποδώσοντες, ίνα με τα χαράς τούτο πίωση και μη στενάζοντες. Αλυσιτελές βάρ ημίν τούτο, προσεύχεστε περί ημών. Πεπιθάμεν γάρ, ότι καλήν συνείδησιν έχομεν, εν πάση καλός θέλοντες αναστρέφεστε. Περισσοτέρος δε παρακαλώ τούτο ποιήσε, ή να τάχειον αποκατασταθώ ημίν. Ο δε Θεός της ειρήνης, ο αναγωγών εν νεκρών των ποιμένα των προβάτων, των μέγαν εν αίματι διαθήκης αιωνίου. Τον Κύριον ημών Ιησούν, καταρτήσε ημάς εν παντή έργο αγαθό, εις το ποιήσε το θέλημα αυτού. Ποιον εν ημίν το ευάρεστον ενώπιον αυτού. Διά Ιησού Χριστού, ο η δόξα εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν.
Let us be attentive.
Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. What shall I render to the Lord for all that he has given me?
Wisdom.
The reading is from the St. Paul's letter to the Hebrews.
Let us be attentive.
Brethren, obey your leaders and submit to them, for they are keeping watch over your souls as men who will have to give account. Let them do this joyfully and not sadly, for that would be of no advantage to you. Pray for us, for we are sure that we have a clear conscience, desiring to act honorably in all things. I urge you the more earnestly to do this in order that I may be restored to you the sooner. Now may the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, the great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood of the eternal covenant, equip you with everything good that you may do his will, working in you that which is pleasing in his sight through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever.
Be unto you, the readers.
Alleluia.
Sophia, ορθή, ακούσομεν του Αγίου Ευαγγελίου, ειρήνη πασί.
And with your spirit.
Εκ του κατά Λουκάν Αγίου Ευαγγελίου το ανάγνωσμα προσκομεν. Το καιρό εκείνο εις ερχομένου του Ιησού, εις την ακόμη να απήντησαν αυτό 10 λεπροί άνδρες, έστησαν πόροθεν, και αυτοί ήραν φωνήν λέγοντες,
Ισού επιστάτα ελέησον ημάς. Και ειδών είπεν αυτοίς, πορευθέντες επιδείξατε αυτούς της ιερεύση. Και γένετο εν το υπάγειν αυτούς εκαθαρίστησαν. Εις δε εξ αυτών, ειδών ότι η άθη υπέστρεψε με τα φωνής μεγάλης δοξάζων των Θεών και έπεσεν επί πρόσωπον παρά τους πόδας αυτού ευχαριστών αυτό. Και αυτός ειν Σημαρίτης αποκριθείς δε ο Ιησούς είπεν ουχή δέκα εκαθαρίστησαν ή δε εννέα πού. Ουκ ευρέθησαν υποστρέψαντες δούνε δόξαν το Θεό ημί ο αλλωμενής ούτος. Και είπεν αυτό, Αναστάς πορεύον, η πίστη σου σε σοκέσε.
The reading is taken from the Gospel according to Saint Luke. Let us be attentive. At that time, as Jesus entered a village, he was met by 10 lepers, who stood at a distance and lifted up their voices and said, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. When he saw them, he said to them, Go and show yourselves to the priests. And as they went, they were immediately cleansed. Then one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice, and he fell on his face at Jesus' feet, giving him thanks. And this man was a Samaritan. Then said Jesus, Were not 10 of you cleansed? Where are the other 9? Was no one found to return and give praise to God except this foreigner? And he said to him, protected by thy power, to thee we may ascribe glory, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. And pleasures of the flesh is worthy to approach or draw near to serve thee, O King of glory, for to serve thee is great and awesome even to the heavenly powers. Yet through thine ineffable and boundless love toward mankind, thou didst unchangeably and immutably become man and served as our high priest. And as Lord of all, has committed to us the celebration of liturgical and bloodless sacrifice. Thou alone, our Lord, our God, rule us over all things in heaven and earth, who art born on the throne of the cherubim, and our Lord of the seraphim and King of Israel, who alone art holy and rest among thy saints, wherefore implore thee, who alone art good and ready to listen, look down upon me, thy sinful and unprofitable servant, and cleanse my soul and my heart from an evil conscience, and enable me by the power of the Holy Spirit, vessel of the priesthood, to stand before this thy holy altar and consecrate thy holy and immaculate body and precious blood. For to thee I come, having bowed my head and beseech thee, turn not thy face away from me, neither reject from among thy children, but make me worthy thy sinful and unworthy servants to offer these gifts unto thee. For thou art the offer, the accepted distributor of Christ our God, and to the ascribed glory, together with the eternal Father and the life-giving Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Ita hierovim Christos ingizundes, και της οποίου τριάδιν το τρισάλιον ύμνο προσάδοντες, πάσαν την ιδιωτική να παθαρή μέρημνα. Τα χειροβήμι συγκοσυγονίζοντε και τη ζωπιό τριάδι του τριψάλιου μήνων προσάδοντε πάσαν την ποιοτική να παθόρη μέρημνα. Ή τα χειροβήμι συγκοσυγονίζοντε και τη ζωπιό τριάδι του τριψάλιου μήνων προσάδοντε πάσαν την ποιοτική να παθόρη μέρημνα.
Thank you.
βασιλεία αυτού πάντοτε, νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
May the Lord our God remember us all in his heavenly kingdom now and ever and unto the end. For the precious gifts here presented, let us pray to the Lord.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
For this whole day, that it may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For an angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For the forgiveness and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For all that is good and beneficial to our souls, and for peace in the world, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
That we may complete the remainder of our lives in peace and penitence, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For a Christian end to our lives, peaceful without shame and suffering, and for a good account before the awesome judgment seat of Christ, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Commemorating our most holy, pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
Διά των εκτερμών του μονογενούς σου Υιού, μεθού ευλογητός εσύ, Συν το Παναγίο και αγαθό και ζωπιό σου πνεύματι, νυν και αείμ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
You.
And with your spirit.
Let us love one another, that with one mind we may confess.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, the Trinity, one in essence and inseparable.
Tas thiras, en sophia proskomen.
Πιστεύω εις ένα Θεό,
Πατέρα Παντοκράτορα,
ποιητή του ουρανού και γης, ορατώνται
πάντων και ευράτων, και εις ένα Κύριον Ιησούν Χριστόν, τον Υιόν του Θεού, τον μονογενή, τον εκ Πατρός εν ηθέντα προπάντων των αιώνων, φως εκ φωτός,
Θεόν αληθινών εκ Θεού
εκ του αληθινού, γεννηθέντα ου πιθέντα, ομοούσιον το Πατρίδιο τα πάντα γένετο, τον δημάς τους ανθρώπους και την Πιτέραν Σωτηρίαν, καταλθόνται εκ των ουρανών και σακορθένται εκ Πνεύματος Αγίου και Μαρίας της Παρθένου και Ενανθρωπίσαντα. Σαυροθένεται υπέρ ημών, επντίου πελάτου και παθόντα και ταφέντα και αναστάντα την τρίτη μέρα της καρφάς.
Και ανελθόντα εις τους ουρανούς και κατεζόμενα δεξιών του Πατρός και πάλι ελκόμενο με τα δόξης,
κρίνε ζώντας και νεκρούς,
ούτης βασιλείας και στο τέλος.
Εις το Πνεύμα το Άγιον των Κύριων των Ζωπιών, των εκ Πατρός προβόμενων, των Συμπατρί και Υιώσι προσκυνούμενων και συνδοξαζόμενων των λαλήσαν διά των προφητών.
Εις μίαν Αγίαν, καθολική και αποστολική εκκλησία,
ομολογώ εν βάπτισμα εις άφης αμαρτιών,
προσδοκώ Ανάσταση νεκρών και ζωήν του μέλλοντος αιώνος. Αμήν.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not created, with the Father through whom all things were made,
who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and of the Virgin Mary, and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and he rose on the third day according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven.
He is seated at the right hand of the Father,
and he will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit,
the Lord, creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets.
In one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen.
Stomen kalos. Στόμεν με τα φόβου, πρόσκομεν την Αγίαν αναφορών, εν ειρήνη προσφέρειν.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, in the love of God the Father, the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you all. Let us lift up our hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord.
Τον επινίκιον ύμνον άδοντα βόντα και κραγόντα και λέγοντα.
And powers, O Master, who loves mankind, we also pray and say, Holy art thou, and all holy, thou begotten Son of thy Holy Spirit. Holy art thou, and all holy, magnificent is thy glory, and still of the world is condemned. Only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. Who having come and having fulfilled all dispensation for us in the night, he's betrayed, or rather surrendered himself to the life of the world. Having taken bread in his holy and immaculate and blameless hands, and having thanked, blessed, and sanctified, and broken, he gave to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, take ye, eat, this is my body, which for you is broken unto remission of sins. Likewise the cup after the supper, saying, Piet ex aftu pandes, tuto esti doema modo disgenisti athikis, to eperimon kepalon evkinomenon isafesin amartion. Drink from it, ye all. This is my blood of the New Testament, which for you and for many is shed unto remission of sins. Therefore, remembering the command of our Savior and all that he endured for us, the cross, the tomb, the resurrection, the third day, the ascension into heaven, sitting at the right hand, the second and glorious coming again. The sanctum son, si prosferomen kata panda, ke dia panda. Again, we offer to thee this rational and bloodless worship. Beseech thee and pray and supplicate thee, send down thy Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts here presented. Make this bread the precious body of thy Christ, and that which is in this cup the precious blood of thy Christ, changing them by the descent of the Holy Spirit. To those that receive them for the purification of the soul, for the remission of sins, for the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, for the fulfillment of the kingdom of heaven, and for the boldness to approach thee neither unto judgment nor unto condemnation. Again, we offer unto thee this reasonable worship for those who have fallen asleep in the faith, the forefathers, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, and every righteous spirit made perfect in faith.
Thank you.
εξαιρέτως της Παναγίας, αχράντου υπερευλογημένης, εν δόξου Δεσποίνης ημών Θεοτόκων και αη Παρθένου Μαρίας.
Άξιον Δεσποίνος αλήθως, μακαρίζηξε τη Θεοτόκων, συνταή μακαρίσον και παναμόμιτσον και μητέρα του Θεού ημών. Την τιμιωτέρα των
μίστη την Κύριε του Αρχιεπισκόπου και Πατρός ημών Ιακώβου, εν χάρισε της Αγίας Εκκλησίας εν ειρήνη, σώνεν ημών ιαρμερεύοντα και ορθοτομούντα των λόγων της εις αληθείας.
Και ον εκαστός κατά διάνοιαν έχει και πάντων και πασών.
And grant us that with one mouth and one heart we may glorify and praise the all honorable and majestic name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
The mercies of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Having remembered all the saints, let us again in peace pray to the Lord.
Give you thanks, O Lord.
For these precious gifts which have been offered and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving God, who has received them at his holy, heavenly, and spiritual altar as an offering of spiritual fragrance, may in return send upon us divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray.
Giving us for the unity of the faith, the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and one another in our whole life to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
Και καταξίωσον ημάς δέσποτα με τα παρησίας ακατακρίτως, τον μάν επικαλείστεσαι, τον επουράνιον Θεόν Πατέρα και λέγειν.
Πάτερ ημών, που εν της ουρανής, αγιαστήτω το όνομά σου, ελθέτω η βασιλεία σου, γεννηθήτω το θέλημά σου, ως εν ουρανώ και επί τη γης, των άρτων ημών των επιούσιων, δώσ' μην σήμερον, και άφηση μην τα φιλήματα ημών, ως και εμείς αφήμεν σε φιλέτς ημών, και εμείς ενέγγεις ημάς πειρασμών, αλλά ρίσσα ημάς από το πονηρού. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Τα σκεφαλά σημών το Κύριο κλείνομεν. By the grace, mercy, and love for us of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Το Αγίο της Αγίης, the Holy Gifts unto the Holy. Μιλίζεται και δημιουργίζεται το όμνος του ημιλιζόμενος ο πάντοτες, ρουμενός ο πάντοτες, θεόμενος. Και μη δέπεται δεπανόμενος τους θείων δοσαϊάζων.
Yeah.
truth of Christ, the Son of the living God, who came in the world to save the sinners, of whom I am the first. I also believe that this is your very immaculate body, and this is your very precious blood. Therefore, I implore you, have mercy on me and forgive me my sins, those of my own will and those not of my own, those by word, those by deed, those I knew and those I did not, and make me worthy blamelessly to partake of your immaculate sacrament for the forgiveness of sins and life eternal. Amen. Unworthy as I am, how can I enter the splendor of the company of your saints? Should I dare the festal chamber stealthily to enter, my garments unfit as they are for the occasion, will give me away, and bound I shall be cast out by the angels. My Lord, my foul soul cleanse, and in your mercy my life redeem. Merciful Master, Lord Jesus Christ, my God, let not these holy gifts to my condemnation prove because of my unworthiness, but to cleansing and sanctification of soul and body, and to the betrothal of life to come, and of your kingdom. For it is good for me to cling to my God, to place him in the hope of my salvation. Of your supper, the mystical and sublime, allow me, Son of God, today to partake. To your adversaries, your mystery I shall not reveal, nor Judas's kiss shall I give to you, but rather as the thief I implore you, my Lord, remember me in your kingdom. Behold, I draw near to Christ, our immortal King and God.
This morning, we would like to have the children and the young people and the teachers come forward for communion so that they can depart and go immediately to their classes. So we ask that you come down the side aisles and come up onto the solea and exit down the center aisle, and you can go down through St. Catherine's Chapel to go to your classes. We will have Andidro here for those up in front who are going to receive communion. We also will have Andidro in the back, by the door back there, so that those who are not receiving communion are able to take a piece of Andidro on their way to classes. So please allow the children and the young people to come forward for communion before the adults come forward to receive.
Μετά φόβου Θεού πίστεως και αγάπης προσέλθετε, with the fear of God, faith and love approach. Yeah, right,
Let us rise, having partaken of the divine, holy, pure, immortal, heavenly life, given in awesome mysteries of Christ. Worthily let us give thanks unto the Lord.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace. Having prayed for a perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless day, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Οτισιόνιος μοσιμών και εσύ την δόξαν να πέμπομεν το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Αγίο Πνεύμα την ίν και αι και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Εν ειρήνη προέλθομεν.
Του Κυρίου δεήθομεν.
Κύριε λέησον, Κύριε λέησον, Κύριε λέησον, Πάτερ Άγιε ευλογήσον.
Ευλογών τους ευλογούντας σε Κύριε,
και αγιάζουν τους επισήπε πειθώτας, σώσον των λαών σου και ευλόγησον την κληρονομίαν σου. Το πλήρωμα της Εκκλησίας σου φύλαξον, αγίασον τους αγαπώντας την επρέπεια του οίκου σου. Σύ αυτούς αντιδόξασον τη θεϊκή σου δυνάμει και μη εγκαταλείπιση μας τους ελπίζοντας επί σε. Ειρήνη το κόσμο σου δώρησε τες Εκκλησίες σου, της ιερεύση, της άρχουση, το στρατό και παντή το λαό σου, ότι πάσα δώσεις αγαθή και πάντορημα τέλειον άνωθεν εστί, καταβαίνουν εξού του Πατρός των φώτων. Και εσύ την δόξαν και ευχαριστίαν και προσκύνησιν αναπέμπομεν, το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύματι, νυν και αΐμ, και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Το όνομα Κυρίου ευλογημένον από του νυν και ως του αιώνων.
Blessed are you, O Lord, teach me your statutes. The choir of the saints has found the fountain of life and the door of paradise. May I also find the way through repentance, for I am the lost and stray sheep. Call me back to you, O Savior, and save me.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, διδαξών με τα δικαιώματά σου. Ανάπαυσον ο Θεός τους δούλους σου και κατάταξον αυτούς εν παραδείσο, όπου χωρεί τον Αγίον Κύριε και οι δικαίοι εκλάψους συνασφωστήρες. Τους και κοιμημένους δούλους σου ανάπαυσον παρόλων αυτών πάντα τα εγκλήματα.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. The tri-brilliance of the God at singleness, let us praise reverently chanting. Holy are you, the beginningless Father, co-beginningless Son, and Holy Spirit. Shine upon us who in faith worship you, and deliver us all from the eternal fire.
Spirit.
spirits of the righteous, perfected in faith. Give rest, O Savior, to the soul of your servant. Bestow upon it the blessed life, which is from you, O loving one.
Στην κατάπαυσή σου, Κύριε, όπου πάντες οι Άγιοι σου
ανατεύονται,
ανάπαυσον, Κύριε, και τα ψυχάς των δούλων σου, ότι μόνος υπάρχεις αθάνατο.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. You are God who descended into Hades, and ended the suffering of all who were in prison. O Savior, also rest the souls of these your servants.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray to you, hear us, and have mercy. Again, we pray for the repose of the departed servants of God, Aditi and Georgia, who have fallen asleep, and for the forgiveness of all their sins, both voluntary and involuntary. May the Lord God place their souls where the righteous repose. Let us ask for the mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and the forgiveness of their sins from Christ our mortal King and God. Let us pray to the Lord.
O God of spirits and of all flesh, who has trampled down death, crushed the power of the devil, and granted life to your world, do you yourself, O Lord, give rest to the souls of these, your servants, Ariti and Yodhia, who have fallen asleep in a place of light, a place of green pasture, a place of repose, where there is no grief, sorrow, or mourning. Forgive every sin which they have committed in word or deed or thought. For you are a good God who loves mankind, for there is no one who lives and does not sin. Only you are without sin. Your righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and your word is truth.
Let us pray to the Lord.
For you are the resurrection, the life, and the repose of your servants, Aditi and Yuria, who have fallen asleep, O Christ our God. And to you we ascribe glory, together with your beginningless Father and your holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Kyrie eleison.
Ότι εσύ Αναστασής η ζωή και η μακαρία ανάπαυσης των κεκοιμημένων δούλων του Θεού αρετής και γεωργίας Χριστέ ο Θεός ημών, και εσύ την δόξαν αναπέμπομεν. Συν του Ανάρχου σου Πατρί και το Παναγίο και αγαθό και ζωπιό σου Πνεύματι, νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Everlasting be your memory, our ever blessed and ever memorable sisters.
Oh,
Ευλογία Κύριο και έλεος αυτού εθ' εμάς, δι' αυτού θεία χάριτη και φιλανθρωπία πάντοτε νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Δόξα Σύ ο Θεός, ελπίσιμον Κύριε, δόξα Σύ.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίου Πνεύματι και νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Κύριε λαΐσον, Κύριε λαΐσον, Κύριε λαΐσον, Πάτερ Άγιε ευλογήσον.
Ο Αναστάς εκ νεκρών, Χριστός ελευθερός Θεός ημών, τες πρεσβείας της Παναχράντου και παραμομαγίας αυτού Μητρός, δυνάμει του Τιμίου και Ζώπιου Σταυρού, προστασίας του Τιμίου Παρανίων δυνάμεων σωμάτων, ηγεσίας του Τιμίου ενδόξου προφήτου προδρόμου και βαπτιστού Ιωάννου, των Αγίων ενδόξων και πανεφήμερων αποστόλων, του Αναγής Πατέρων ημών μεγάλων εικόνικου εικόνων διδασκάλων, του Αναγής Πατρός ημών Ιωάννου Αρχιεπισκόπου Κωνσταντινοπόλεως του Χρυσοστόμου, των Αγίων ενδόξων Καλλινίκων Μαρτύρων, των Ασίγων Θεοφόρων Πατέρων ημών, των Αγίων και Δικαίων Θεοπατώρων Ιωακήμ και Άνιης, των Αγίων Αντωνίου, Οσίου, του Μεγάλου, Αντωνίου του Νέου Ασκητού, του Ενβυρία, Γεωργίου Νεομάρτυρος, του Εν Ιωαννίνης και πάντων των Αγίων Ελίσης και σώσε εμάς, ως αγαθός και φιλάνθρωπος και ελέημον Θεός. Τυφών των Αγίων Πατέρων ημών, Κύριε Σου Χριστέ ο Θεός, ελέησον και σώσον ημάς. Η Αγία Τριάστε φυλάξε πάντες ημάς. Καλημέρα σας. Good morning. Today is the feast of Saint Andonios, of Saint Anthony, and so we wish those who may be celebrating their names day today, Andonios or Andonia, and also tomorrow is the feast of Saint Athanasios, so those who perhaps might be celebrating that feast day, we wish them a happy names day for these 2 days. Tomorrow, and speaking on that, tomorrow we will have Orthros and Divine Liturgy downstairs in St. Catherine's Chapel, with the Orthros beginning at 8:30, followed by the Divine Liturgy. This morning, following the distribution of our Andiedro, we will be having our stewardship brunch. And this brunch is given each year by the parish in January for all of our stewards and friends of this community. And this year's brunch is given by the family of Georgia Papadimitriou, of course, as you know, passed away about a month and a half ago, and this morning we commemorated her with the memorial service for her 40 days. And the family has graciously underwritten the cost of this brunch. So those who are able to stay with us, of course, are invited to do so down in Plato Hall. There are a number of announcements in your bulletin, so please take a bulletin and you can refer to them. Tomorrow evening is our adult, we continue with our adult Bible study in St. Catherine's meeting room, and that begins tomorrow evening at 7 o'clock. We will continue with St. Paul's epistle to the epistle to Timothy, and again, as that is tomorrow evening at 7 p.m. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. In listening to the gospel readings that we hear during our Divine Liturgies each Sunday, we come to realize quickly that many of the readings are actually stories. Stories of instruction, stories of growth, and of spiritual edification for each of us to help understand our faith and the ministry of Christ even better. And this morning's reading is an example of that. This gospel reading makes us aware of the need to say thank you. Isn't it amazing what a simple thank you can do? And isn't it somewhat disappointing when we do something for someone and they forget to speak those two simple but very important words? And it happened to Jesus at least once that we know of, as we heard in this morning's gospel reading. We were told in the reading that Jesus was on his way with his disciples to the great city of Jerusalem, traveling along the border between Samaria and Galilee. And as he was going into a village, 10 men with leprosy met him. And they stood at a distance and called out with a loud voice, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." And when Jesus saw them, he said, "Go show yourselves to the priests." And as the 10 men proceeded to go to the temple, as Jesus instructed them, they were immediately cleansed from the disease of leprosy. One of them was a Samaritan, and he saw that he was immediately healed, and he turned back.
and came back to Jesus, praising him in a loud voice. And he threw himself down in front of Jesus, and he thanked him. But what did Jesus say? Jesus said, "Were there not 10 of you? Were not all of you, all 10 of you, cleansed? Where are the other 9? Has no one returned to give praise to God except this foreigner?" And then Jesus said to this grateful Samaritan, he said, "Rise and go. Your faith has made you well." So that was the question Jesus had for those 10 men on that day. Where are the other 9? And that's a question that has been asked by priests and Sunday church school teachers for 2,000 years. 10 were healed, but only one bothered so much as to figuratively write a thank you note. Where were the other 9? The important thing this morning for us to take away with us is the need to say thank you. I would like to believe and hope that that's why we are here and every Sunday. That it is out of a genuine sense of gratitude for what God has done and continues to do for us. We look at our society today and we see that it slowly is becoming more and more self-centered. And we seem to have dispensed with the need to acknowledge and thank people around us for all of the goodness that comes our way. But it is important to say thank you, whether to God or to others who have blessed your life. And along these lines, I would like to share this story with you. Some of you might remember the television news program On the Road with Charles Kuralt. And on one of those broadcasts, Kuralt was in Moscow. And an older gentleman with a lapel full of war medals approached Charles Kuralt. And this older man was a Russian doctor from World War II. He was captured by the Germans and he was placed in a POW camp. Now, the Germans were particularly hard on Russian POWs, and by comparison, Americans in the same camp had an abundance of food. But the Russians were only given a bowl of thin, cold turnip soup once a day. And as a result, thousands of them died. And with tears streaming down this doctor's face, this Russian doctor told Charles Kuralt about a group of American soldiers who risked their very lives to smuggle food to the starving Russians. And he wrote down a list of their names as best as he could remember them, and he asked Kuralt to try and find them. And it was a painstaking task. But Kuralt found each of the American soldiers who were still living. And he arranged for a meeting. And the old Russian doctor was flown to Phoenix, Arizona, to be reunited with some of the men who risked their lives to save him from starvation. And in the Phoenix airport, after 40 years, the Russian doctor saw his fellow captives and was finally able to say thank you. So I say again, it is important to say thank you. In our gospel reading this morning, Jesus healed 10 men with leprosy, but only one, as we heard, returned to say thank you. And Jesus was disappointed. It wasn't that he needed their gratitude. He most certainly did not. But how could they truly be healed both physically and spiritually if they didn't have a sense of gratitude in their hearts? God doesn't need our thanks because he's all sufficient. He doesn't need anything. Contrary, it is we who need to say thank you, because a sense of gratitude is one of the surest signs of spiritual health. Saying thanks is a way of reminding ourselves that all we have, we owe to God. It is so easy in an affluent culture such as ours to think that the blessings we enjoy were earned because of our own efforts. We sometimes forget the people who gave of themselves that we might have this land of plenty. And it's many times easy to forget that God is the source of all these blessings. What we need to understand is that when Christ healed them, he healed their bodies as well as their souls from sin. Our gospel reading this morning makes the point that all the leprous men, all 10 of them were healed in the sense of physical cleansing of their condition. But only one of these, only one leper, was truly made well. I say that because physical healing is not always necessary to be in a whole happy person, but spiritual cleansing is. The 10th leper was freed from physical illness, but true freedom came in his attitude of gratitude that he displayed before Jesus. Finally, this morning, my dear friends, there is one more thing that must be said, that true gratitude results in greater service. We don't know what happened to this 10th man. Our gospel reading doesn't say. Did he become a disciple? Was he one of those who later gave his life in Christ's behalf? Perhaps. We don't know. When people are truly grateful, however, they have a need to repay their debts. And if it is a debt that cannot be repaid, they seek to pass on their gratitude and kindness to someone else. So we need to realize that saying thank you is a statement of our faith. St. Paul advises us to give thanks in all circumstances. The ability to develop a spirit of gratitude, regardless of the situation, is a statement that we believe that God is at work in our universe and that all things work for the good of those who love him. So, my dear brothers and sisters, that is why we are here this morning. And that is what our divine liturgy is all about. Giving thanks to our Lord for his blessings. To say thank you. Thank you for healing us. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for watching over us. I suppose that scarcely one out of 10 Americans today will truly say thank you. But for those who do, it is a statement of gratitude, a statement of character, a profession of faith, a petition of grace, and a commitment of worship. Amen.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, ευλόγη η ψυχή μου των Κύριων,
και πάντα τα εντός μου το όνομα το Άγιον αυτού.
Ευλόγη ψυχή μου τον Κύριον και μη επιλανθάνου πάσα στα ανταποδόσεις αυτού.
Τον επιλατεύοντα πάσα στα ανομία σου, τον ιόμενον πάσα στα νόσου σου.
Τον λυτρούμενον εκτορά στη ζωή σου, τον στεφανούντα σε ενελέη.
Επιπλώντα εν αγαθή στην επιθυμία σου ανακαινιστήσετε όσα ετού είναι ότι σου.
Ιόν ελεημοσύνας ο Κύριος και κρίμα πάση της αδικουμένης.
Εζόρισε τα σωδούς αυτού το Μωυσή της Ισραήλ τα θελήματα αυτού.
Μακρόθυμος και πολυέλεος, ο Κυστέλος οργιστήσετε, ουδέν εις τον αιώνα μείνει.
Ο κατά τας ανομίας ημών επίσεν ημίν, ουδέν κατά τας αμαρτίας ημών ανταπέν.
Ότι κατά το ύψος των ουρανών από της γης εκρατέωσε Κύριος το έλεος αυτού επί τους φοβουμένους αυτό.
Καθώς ο απέχωση ανατολέ από δυσμό, εμάκρυνε να θυμώ τα σανομίας ημών.
Άνθρωπος ως υπόρτωσε ημέρε αυτού, ως η άνθος του αυρού ούτως εξανθεί.
Ότι το πνεύμα δήθεν εν αυτού και ουχ υπάρξει και ουπ επιγνώσετε τι τον τόπο